And now it's time to paint the hair. I have base coated it with a light brown color. The hair is base coated with the rucksack tan, and now we are going to apply a wash, and it will be some kind of we're going to apply the Sepharin Sepia on the hair and let it dry, and then we're going back in with the rucksack tan to paint in the midtones, and then we're mixing this with the Melnot White highlight to get the final highlights on the hair, and then we're done. So it will be quick and easy. Let's apply the Sepia on the hair. Try to avoid painting this on the skin. We don't want to waste time on correcting too many mistakes. While we wait for the wash to dry, let's paint the base black. Now when we have the black color, let's grab a half decent brush. This one works fine. Don't want to paint with a fine brush now while just applying loads of black paint. We want this to go fast. I like to paint the bases black before I start the basing with the materials or the stuff it's gonna apply, because it helps with the shadowing, and sometimes if you have the different color on the base, it can shine through. We're taking the base color now again. This is the first highlight, rucksack tan. I do think it's thin enough. I usually fill my colors in the can to make the process of diluting them later easier. And just do some kind of quick edge highlight with the brush. Doesn't have to be precise, just try to grab some of the raised areas of the hair. If you mess it up, you can just wash it again and then redo this step. The wash will hide your mistakes quite easily. It's a quick fix. I'm happy with that. Now it's time to grab some base coat and mix it with a small amount of Melnot White highlight. And this is where I like to check how bright the color is compared to the old. Paint it on your thumb when you're checking how diluted the paint is, and you can see when it's drying the difference. Don't apply it all over her hair like you did with the last. With the base coat, mid-tone, or highlight, whatever, first highlight step. Let's try to put it a little bit more on the raised areas. Like so. And now mix a lot of Melnot White highlight to your highlight color, so you have really bright, light, bright, no, bright, bright brown. Like this. See, almost too white. Apply it on the most raised areas. This looks quite weird, very bright. But it's fine because we will make a final wash with the sepia to just bring it back down and blend it with the base color. So put some wash on your palette and dilute it a bit with a drip of water. Glaze it over the hair. There we go. Just to bring down the brightest part. There we go, quite happy with the hair. Now it's time to fix the base, and then she's done. And when the base is ready, we will take a look and see if we need to apply some blood on the weapons to get a nice effect, or if we can leave it as is.